Today, we will have a first look at the 1401. Here we have some equipment for experiments, currently the 1401 CPU, a 1402 card reader and punch, a 1403 chain printer, some 729 tape drives, and an old 26 card punch. The 1401 has no operating system or BIOS as we know it today. To run a program, it has to be transferred directly into the main memory, and then it may be started manually or automatically. For entering the program, there are mainly three possibilities. The classic way via the switches, which is more or less ridiculous, but at least somehow interesting. The more sophisticated way via punch cards. And the most elegant way via tape. Additionally, it's possible to enter data via a terminal, the so-called 1407 inquiry station. I can't show it at the moment because it's still in repair, but that's not useful to enter a program anyway. The third possibility to load a program from tape involves loading a tape onto the tape drive, like so, loading it or rewinding it in this case, waiting till the ready lamp lights, and press tape load, which normally would load the program into memory and start it. How to get the program onto the tape in the first place will also be part of a future tutorial. Let's try to enter some data using the switches. The console interface of the 1401 is very rudimentary. It's in no way as impressive as other machines with tens of switches and hundreds of lights. Plus, it's in no way comfortable, as it's not possible to use it at your desk. Nevertheless, it's sufficient for testing and debugging or modifying a few bytes. First, let's have a look what's currently in the main memory. Let's inspect, for example, the memory locations 10, 11 and 12. First, set the address switch to 10. Now set the mode switch to character display and press start. The B register shows 8 and 2. Let's see. 8 and 2 is a 0. Address 11, start, BA8, B and A8 is an H. Address 12, start, BA41, B and A 41 is an E. That's very exhausting, but there's a better way. Set the mode switch to storage printout and make sure the address switches are set to an address below 100. And now let's see what happens when I press start. Yeah, you see the printer printed something. I can use also the start button on the printer, it's the same function. Now let's see what we printed out. You can see a nice memory extract from address 1 to address 132. And at position 10, you can see the 0 again, and the H, and the E, and many more bytes. Nicely printed on paper. Now to change the storage location, set the mode switch to alter, check the address switch, set it to 10 in this case, enter the bit pattern via these switches, for example 1, and toggle enter, and you see at the B register we now entered a 1. Let's set the next address 11. Let's change the bit pattern to 2. Toggle enter. We see a 2 at address 11. Select address 12. Set the switch to, for example, 3. And keep in mind to set the check bit, or parity. Again, set enter, and you see we have a 3 in address 12. Now set the mode switch again to storage printout. Press start. Let's see. Here you can see address 10 is our 1, address 11 is our 2, address 12 is our 3. I think you agree that it would be a pain to enter a whole program this way. A better way to fill memory, at least during development, may be the use of punched cards. Let's create some example cards at our card punch. Let's check the cards. Hello World, the Quick Brown Fox, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Seems okay. Let's take them and put them in the card reader. And now it's the front of the card reader. Let's press load. You see one card has been fed through, the other two are still in the hopper. Now let's inspect the memory. Cards are always being read into memory from address 1, independent of the address switches. So let's check again that the memory switches are set below 100. And let's create a storage printout. And you see Hello World is now in the memory beginning at address number 1. Out. You can see the storage area has been overwritten by the second card. Cards are always read at to address 1. This is hardwired and it's not possible, for example, to read the next card into an area behind the first card. However, it's still possible to store programs which are longer than one punch card, but that will be covered in one of the next tutorials.